And why is it when you drive in the city, you never have bugs on your windshield, yet when you drive in the country, your windshield's covered with bugs? That doesn't make any sense. With all the room out there, why are they playing in the middle of the road? I don't know. I have bug troubles at home. I have a garden where I grow tomatoes. And I had a lot of bugs in my medicinal tomato garden. So the garden store says, you need to buy a carton of ladybugs. And I said, well, how many ladybugs come in a carton? And she says, 1,000 to 1,500 ladybugs. And even the ladybugs were like, fuck. That's a lot of ladybugs. And as I was holding this carton, all I could think was, if I opened this up in a crowded elevator, that would be like some weird terrorist attack, wouldn't it? And people would be like, ladybugs, ladybugs. But it wouldn't be the ladybugs that would be scary. It would be the fact that there was 1,000 of them, because 1,000 kittens are scary if you think they have organizational skills. And then I thought, well, how would I control the ladybugs with their natural enemy, the praying mantis? But you can't buy those in bulk, so I thought I would get 6 and crochet them tiny uniforms. And that was when I put my bong down. Because you have to know when to stop, people.
I think that was my 45, was it?
All right, there we go. So, but look, folks, you know, this is really fun. You come out. I try to lift spirits. I try to, you know, sometimes people don't feel good about themselves. I try to make them feel better. Just do me a favor. Whatever you do in life, you just be happy and you be proud of yourself. I remember when I was a little girl, my dad, he would give me advice. He would say, Karen, always be proud of yourself, because no matter what you do, there's always going to be some jerk standing there cutting you down. That's just how your mother is. I know my parents hate each other. I don't know why they're still married. I told my mother she wasn't thinking positive, so she joined a widow's club. They're nuts. They came out to visit me for a month. Oh, yes, the people that gave me life came to suck it right back out of me. Have you ever tried to take a stroll down memory lane with your parents talking about your childhood, and after listening to them for a few minutes, you're like, were you even there? What the hell are you talking about? I'm like, hey, Ma, do you remember on my 10th birthday when I cracked my head open on a rock? And she's like, oh, I remember a duck got in the car. And then my father's like, that wasn't a duck, that was your Uncle Andy. Someone yelled, you want a beer? He thought they said the aliens are here. And yelled, they're going to probe my ass, everyone duck. And that's when the duck got in the car. And my father is so cheap, he worries more about money than death. He left this message on my answering machine. Karen, your mother and I are going on vacation. Now, if we die on vacation, don't fly the bodies home. The airlines are going to try and stick it to you with the price. You cremate the bodies and you mail them home. There's a flat rate priority box. Your mother will fit into nicely. I prefer a bubble envelope. So if you don't hear from us for a while and you get something in the mail, open it carefully. It's either your dead parents or some fudge. It will be a surprise.